Okay, so now it's time to escape again. So let's just pick up our things here. Yeah, let's see, what do we have? We have this pistol and shotgun. Kind of wish I had my chica now, but okay, let's go out and see. Okay, so the first area, the holding area here, there's a whatever it is.
You got it yourself. I'll go stand there.
Metal detector here, so you don't go through that. But we can easily just pop out here and just wait for that guy to go down the stairs before we take out these two guys here.
The important thing is nothing else shakes. Okay.
I think he's far enough now. We can take them out. This guy, he's messing with some kind of bomb or whatever it is. Okay, so let's deal with the guy downstairs.
Second floor. Come in, second floor.
Make up your mind. Oh yeah, he get a roll call here. And if you let him respond to that, you actually get a maul point. So I think we'll just wait a bit here. Have a little look around in the lockers. Oh, there's an AK here. Yeah, let's take the AK.
Reporting. Group 8 left the facility using Tunnel 2.
Roger that, second post. Carry on.
Okay, so there was his response. So we can knock him out. Take the journal over here. Let's go find that safe. We picked the key for. Safe is upstairs here. Oh, there's also a low-life pistol, but not much in the safe, it seems. So I guess we're done here with the first area, so let's go into the first big area here. Some kind of big workshop here, or whatever it is. Just flip the breakers here to get some more darkness in this room. There's a lot of guys here, but most of them are just wandered off to a to a dark, secluded spot corner, so you can easily take them out. So we'll just go up here on the left side, on the right side, I guess. And you will just wait for this guy to turn around. Then we move up and blow out that lamp. Petroleum lamp or whatever it is. There he goes. So we can just sneak in here. In the container. Through the containers here. Into a little back room here.
Attention all personnel.
And we need to go through that door over there. There's a bit of a light there. I want to take out the light. Don't really have a silenced weapon. But luckily there's actually a silenced Kalashnikov in the locker here, so I think we'll just go for that. Just wait for these guys to go a little bit further away. Just that locker, just right ahead here. That's the silencer. So now we can take out light from a distance here. Let's see these guys here. Yeah, they look to be far enough ahead. Oh, what's going on here? What the hell? Oh, I see. Okay. Yeah. One guy. On the far side. And the other guy walking back and forth here. I wonder if he'll hear if we shoot that light. I'm a bit unsure here actually. I don't know. Maybe you'd hear the lights go out. Nah, let's just try it. Let's just try it here. Oh yeah, he heard it. Or at least he got some suspicious. So I guess we'll just have to wait a bit here. Okay, he calmed down again. Good. Maybe we should also take out the other lights at the ceiling. Maybe that's a good idea. Let's just do that. Oh, double shot. That was not intended. And now he freaks out again. Oh, he's coming this way. So we better stay out of his light here, I guess. Okay, that was quick. He didn't feel like investigating that. Okay, so I guess we are in the darkness here. So let's just go in the store here, into the resting area, or barrack or whatever it is.
What the hell happened?
Why? You don't know about the breach?
Sure, I know the place. I served there for a short time.
Well, last year there was one hell of an incident. The guy said that when they came to relieve the watch, all
there's a couple of guys in the room to the left here.
So the lieutenant sent some scouts to the Nazi post on the other end. They returned and said it was the same shit there.
And these two guys are having a conversation exactly about some of our exploits in the first game.
Who could have killed so many men?
It was us, dude.
Whatever it was, it wasn't human. Might have been the creature some call the Dark Rail Tracer. One of the guys supposedly made him mad by taking a nut off on a rail junction.
That's ridiculous.
If it wasn't the Rail Tracer, story is even crazier. Must have been a Hansa or Polish task force.
How could a task force that size get there undetected? Now, one guy that's possible. I heard of a traitor who smuggled a spy of some kind to the front line through the Smiti in a rail car undercarriage. But 30 guys? Nah, that's too
yeah, that seems...
We'll never know, but somehow it happened. They've tripled the guards at the bridge since then, which reminds me, you should take a walk around the barracks, so that nobody sneaks up on us.
Yeah, I think it's too late for that, dude. Oh, what the fuck? Okay, why the fuck did he hear that? Okay, that was strange. They didn't hear us taking out the first guy, but somehow they, for some strange reason, they heard us taking out the second guy. I don't think I've ever experienced being caught taking out a guy, or they heard you taking out a guy.
Why the hell am I always the dumb shit on guard duty?
Okay, but there's just four guys in here. Two in that room and two in this room. And this guy just walks away, so we can take him out. And this guy doing his exercises, you can't actually take him out until he's drops down to the ground.
No sleeping.
Here we go. And the last two guys here, conveniently has, come on, take him out. has their backs to you. This guy sometimes, he of course can walk in from here, so just be careful that he's walking away here. Not coming from the room. In that case, wait a bit, I guess. Can we take out this? Yeah, we can just jump a bit here and take out the light, even though it's hard to reach. So that's the key for the safe we saw in that other room. It's also the journal over here. Okay, but not much else in here to look at. Let's go get the safe before we leave this area. Oh, there's a silenced revolver here. With a scope? Yeah, that could come in handy maybe. Okay, but now we have two silenced weapons. So we are pretty well covered, I think. This, we'll try to go through it without killing anyone, I think. So the easiest way is just out here. Instead of going back the same way, we'll just go out here. Well, we can't take out that one. Okay, but it's a bit light to the right here. We need to go to the right here, so I think... can we take out this light without these guys getting suspicious? Let's just wait for them to finish their conversation. Yeah, I'm not sure. Yeah, it does look a bit light, and there's a couple of guys ahead. Maybe they'll see us. Yeah, let's take out this light here. It's probably a sensible thing to do. And this guy didn't get alerted. Great. Okay, so we'll just move up on the right side here, ignoring these guys.
Hey you, down there. Watch out for your head.
Okay. Two more guys here having a conversation. And if you listen to that conversation, you also get a mole point. And then they'll stop what they're doing, and one of them will go for a smoke break, and the other will go and have a rest as well. So, and he will actually be so kind and turn off the lights over in that part of the room. So that's nice of him, I guess. So he's the guy going for a smoke, and we will have to take him out. And there's the guy, goes for a break. So now we can just leave this area. Pop into the next area. There's also a point of no return. Yeah, let's just take him out. Just for the heck of it. He has some stuff, so we can take that. So now we go through this door here. And we can't go back. So if you're missing something here, now it's too late. So the next room here is some kind of processing center or whatever. Just hop out over here in the corner and wait for this guy to look the other way. There's also a guy up there. Make sure he doesn't see you when you take out this light here.
Yeah, I'm ready.
We need to go down the little room here, pick up the key for the safe. And there's a service crew that's doing some maintenance check here, and I would advise that you let them complete their maintenance check in peace. You actually get a mole point for that, and it also makes it a lot easier to get through this level here, or get through this room here. We'll just do that. So we'll just go in the other corner here, circle around this service crew here, wait for them to complete the first check. Yeah, I think they're finished now. We can take out the... Turn off the lights here. Go up the ladder here. Oops. Yeah, it did it again there, I think. Dismounting a ladder. And that light over there to the right will turn out when they reach the second step of their circus, their maintenance check. Oh, but here's a scope ticker. Pretty cool. I think we'll take that definitely. Swap out this stupid AK. Okay, so second step, they're already on the second step of the service check here. We just need to go down here and go to the grate. Drop down on below the floor here. And I think I actually did it again. Made a bit of a noise when it dropped down.
Standard.
Great, got that.
But not enough to make them too interested, I think. Okay, so let's see here. There should be a guy coming over here. So just wait for him before you pop up or the hole here. So he doesn't spot you. Where is he? Oh, there he is. Yeah, okay, he's in position, so we can just get up here, take him out.
Okay, Ladna.
Methanol output at the separator.
My own ass.
Normal.
Flow rate.
Be all right. This.
All right.
Take out this guy in the corner here.
A-okay.
Heat exchanger temperature.
Standard.
And I think we'll just take the shortcut down below the floor here. I think there's a guy coming over in this corner, so we're down in the... Yeah, there's a guy coming here, so it's probably best to use the tunnel here to get over to this side of the corner, to this side of the room. Yeah, I think we can get up here without him seeing us. Huh? Okay, I did it again. Are you kidding me? Okay, but I think we made it. I think they're on the last step of their service check here. And we can see the supervisor in that little control room over there. We just wait for him to finish his commands. Commanding the service team, and before we go up to the room, we need to flip a lever to stop this fan from spinning so we can crawl through here. Okay, but that was it. The service check is complete. So now they are off duty and go for smokes, all of them. And the supervisor also conveniently put his back to the entrance here. So we can just sneak into his little room here, to his little control booth. Open the safe here. And also pick up the notebook. Turn off the fan. And be on our merry way here. Nobody's looking. Yeah, we're good here. So let's go into the next area, the warehouse. Okay, so this next part I actually decided to redo it because there's a safe in here that is pretty much impossible to get the key for unless you take out every last one of these guys. Because there's a guy standing out in the middle and he can see pretty much a lot of the room, and he's standing in a very lit space, so it's pretty hard to take him out without one of the others noticing. So I decided to redo it and just skip the safe here. So first things first, that's the journal, and take out this guy on the corner here. Just sneak up on the right side here, and we need to go over this little boardwalk over to the middle shelves in the middle of the room here.
Whatever you say. Let's cross-check it later then, just in case we miss something.
Sure thing.
Also, this guy humming, he's pretty annoying. He walks back and forth, and he's also always in the light, so it's pretty hard to take him out as well. And you can't really knock out these lights in the ceiling here, so it's pretty annoying. But okay, let's get up here. Oh, we managed it actually this time without making noise. There's also a custom pistol here with an infrared scope and a long barrel. I think we just swap to that. We already have a silenced weapon. We don't need two. Okay, so we'll just make sure the coast is clear here first. There's a guy down below here, yeah. And that guy walking back and forth. He can probably also see us if we try to get across here. Yeah, and he's coming back now. God damn it. But there's a lot of dudes in this room. Yeah, that's a guy talking about that he can be seen from far, and he can see far. He's a really annoying guy, that guy standing there by the lift. The truck lift. Okay, need to go over here. Jump down here. Just be careful when you jump down. It's very easy to make noise. Yeah, that guy. Annoying guy. Oh, I think he heard us. Okay, but there's the safe. Okay, here. Let's see. Oh, god damn it. Made too much noise. Jumping down. Shit. There's a lot of dudes here. If you get spotted, it's probably gonna end in the bloodbath. Either you take them out quickly or they will take you out. And there's the key over there. But like I said, I tried getting the keys, but it took a very long time, maybe 15 minutes or so. But careful moving around and putting out the lights and taking out guys. And I found it was a bit boring to watch, so I just decided to skip it and redo this part. Yeah, there's nothing much, nothing else to do for us to do here. Let's just go to the exit tunnels here. Give them a little tune on the way out here. Okay, but this is the exfiltration point. Is right ahead here.
Are we going to stand here much longer?
Yeah, we should be coming back from the war soon. Did you ever do watch duty there?
And you get a moral point also for listening to these guys having a conversation. Oops. Yeah, one of them can spot you a bit here because that box was split in the light. So yeah, just jump up here and up to the... Oh shit. Jump up to here and over in the corner. Wait for this little squad to come by. And they can't see you up here. But the other guys are soon finished here, I think. Yeah, that was the moral point for listening to them.
Weird shit starts happening after a six-hour watch.
Maybe, but somebody is stealing the parts and food.
Probably one of ours, waiting till our backs are turned, then selling shit to Hansa.
Either way.
But okay, pretty much actionless episode, just sneaking past everything and taking out a couple of guys. So we can just jump down here. Keep the sandbags between you and them, so they can't spot you. Get into the next part of the tunnel here. There's just a single guy between us and the exit point now, so we'll just take him out. So that was pretty much it for this part. So now we meet our good old acquaintance, Andrew the blacksmith, and so we'll see what tips he has for us to proceed here. So we'll see what happens next time, I guess. So thanks for watching.
Stay down, or your brain goes splat. Wait a minute. Artyom, is it you?